is Ava. She's 6 months old, and she is a wonderful baby girl. I love every second being with her, just watching her smile, watching her play with things, and just being around her. She's a beautiful girl, and she's just the greatest thing in the world.
I have a little 16-month spark plug named Sophia. Everyone says that, you know, when you have a daughter, she's going to be wrapped around your finger. And prior to all this, I said, no, she's not, but she really is.
I have two children. Caleb is 8 years old, and Ainsley is 4. Definitely a big difference between a boy and a girl. Caleb is a very active guy. He's a sweet kid, but he's like any 8-year-old boy's into mischief. Ainsley is a little bit more high-strung than Caleb is. A lot more emotional. A lot of times she cries, and I'm like, why are you crying?
You can read all the books. You can hear the teachings. You can have people tell you, this is what it's like to be a dad. This is what it's like to be a parent. And you never really are able to get into it until you actually have a child.
She's been able to teach me to be more patient. There's certain times where I want to get up and go and do something, and she's not ready to do it.
She taught me that I can't control everything. She just told me that, you know, life is sometimes random. One other very important thing I learned is if you put your daughter on your shoulders to give her a horsey ride, make sure you check the diaper first.
They've definitely taught me back to the whole selflessness, certainly that I'm no master of selflessness, but it's not about you.
It's not just like the big memories, it's all the little ones. If I'd be like lying on the floor and she'd come up to me and she just like start jumping, climbing on top of my body and hopping on top of me with just the biggest smile on her face, or if I'd be throwing her up and down, or if she'd just be bouncing on the bed or something like that, I mean, there's really nothing comparable to that. It's just the everyday joys of life. That's my favorite part.
My dad was very firm and black and white guy when it came to rules, but he also, he wasn't an overreactor to bad situations. So from what he showed me as far as just love, and that no matter what crisis may come, that it can be worked through, it can be prayed through, that your faith will see you through, and we've got each other.
You know, my dad really just taught me to be kind to others and to listen to other people, and just being able to be there for her, and just watching her grow up. I just love being able to see her change so much.
And everyone can say that their dad was there. My dad would always make time for me. I mean, that means a lot to me, especially in retrospect. And I guess that's kind of what I want to be for my own daughter. I always want to be there for her. I always see stories of girls who are, you know, very pretty, but for some reason they said, my dad never told me I was pretty, and that really had such an impact on the rest of their lives. And I never want my daughter to be like that. I want to be the person who will tell her that I love her, the person that I say, you know, you are beautiful whenever chance arises. Sophia, we love you, and you are beautiful.
Fatherhood is like
a psychological experiment to see how long I can go without sleep.
Being a teacher?
Probably the most important thing I'll ever do in my life.
Fatherhood's like the greatest job in the world.